Good evening, everyone. My name is Heath Haskins, Code Primate, and tonight we are joined by Mr. Seniac, and what are we going to be doing, sir?
Wow, so when the biggest need the best, they call Code Primate for this awesome job. I need some sort of sawmill set up.
Sawmill?
And it is a sawmill, right?
It's going to be a beast, yes. I heard you were jelly of Mr. Midget.
I mean, you made such a contraption. I don't expect anything similar. I'm just a simple guy with simple needs. He's just got some kind of thing you've seen, like a Marvel supervillain.
Mr. Seniac, we meet again.
His one is scary. It scares me to look at it, Midget's sawmill setup. I'm just a simple guy, Code. I'm just a simple guy. He has a simple need to chop wood.
But you deserve the best, just like everyone. And I think we're going to do the same. We're going to give you something that's going to give you that same awesomeness, that same gumshoe that you need. Okay?
Yes, I have full faith in you.
So?
I have full faith in you.
Hang tight one second. We got to break this down. I mean, it's nice and pretty and everything. And I know.
I love the design. I made this beautiful. And then Co comes in and says, it's got to go.
So we're just going to wreck this real quick. Basic design.
You came in and you said, Seniac, you got no planning permission.
You're out right, of so, zoning, zoning regulations. Everything's out of whack here. So.
So you kind of worked out to how high it needed to be. I placed one down now, so I think it's another 4 to get it to the optimal height you need, Code.
Yep, I think we're going to bring it this direction, and the second height that's up there, that should be good, because we're going to need to parry it off this direction. That way anything under 10 goes that direction. Anything over 10 is going to come out this direction, and we've already played with some logic. We're going to get that set up for him. We'll get him a... one of those, either quad. Do you want a quad or a dual? I think a dual would be fine.
Dual is just fine. I'm again just a simple guy. I'm really excited though because I really like the idea of if it's not long enough that it goes in a different direction. That's kind of cool.
Mm-hmm.
That's really cool. Right. So I think we need just a few more now.
Yep.
Let's get those shouldn't up be there. Far too far off the actual height. One more should be it. Yep. Now this is my pet peeve in this game is placing conveyors.
Oh, building in general, I despise it. It's the worst.
Right. Okay, let me know with your good eyes if that is high enough, or do we need one more?
I'm going to throw one more just to top it off here.
Have you got it?
I've got it. It's that bottom one that's over there. You can still see it on your screen.
He's got it.
Boom.
Oh, there perfect Code. That was beautiful.
That should be good.
That's beautiful.
It's good.
This is all really right. High. I'm liking how high this is already. I just want to run and jump off into a big swimming pool. Splash.
Okay. Enough messing around. Seriously. This is serious business we got going here.
Okay, we're serious guys doing a serious job.
I'm just going to start breaking pieces off and start throwing them on here.
Is any of this wood down here in your way?
Nope. You are perfect. Right where it's at.
Ooh, I'm perfect.
There's one. Except for the fact we don't have any straights. Okay, we still have some straights over here. I can take these.
We should have some straights. I do have in my storage barn, my newly built storage barn, a load of boxes of conveyor straights. So if you... is there enough, or should I get some more?
I think we're good.
Oh, brilliant, Code. Brilliant.
Do you happen to have one of the... switch conveyor.
The one that pushes it in different directions.
Yeah, the big bar.
No, I can go and buy one now. That would be my job. Yay! I'm helpful.
I'm helping.
It's like in school when you do like an assignment and you do all the work and then so, you know, you put somebody else's name on it so they also can take credit. I'm that guy taking credit.
Right.
Is it called the switch conveyor?
I think so. And you're going to need the one that, if we're coming towards you, goes to the right.
Oh, the straight conveyor switch.
Yeah, I think there's two of them. There's one that switches to the left and one that switches to the right.
I'll buy both because I'm not very good.
Sounds good. We're good.
Right, let's get it. Pick it up. Run. So it's just a straight send. It's not the one that goes in a... It looks like a crisp... Oh, no, it's not that one. Is it that one? No. Send your stuff where it needs to go. No, I don't think it's that one. Right. I'll soon find out when I bring it to you and the look of disappointment on your face when I got it wrong. Right. Buy it. I want to buy. Let me buy. Thank you. Right, okay, I've got both of them. Let me see if you approve of my purchase.
I'm just going to be playing Jenga over here while you're messing right, around again.
Oh. This one? Is that one of them?
Wrong.
No! This one!
Perfect. Yes. That's the one we need.
Brilliant!
All right, hold on.
Press my car up a bit. Beautiful.
Oh, okay, so. Wrong way around. Hold on.
I'm really excited to actually see this work and go in different directions and then chop. Right, let's place these switches the right way around so we continue to move.
And this is going to be on.
Yeah.
So that should measure the 10 and then logically move. There you go. And then it'll come on in here, and then it'll just...
Now, what's the reason for it being so high?
When it gets cut over here, the wood's got to drop somewhere. So it's got to drop back down so we can take it back over here to get back on track with all the rest of the wood.
Okay. I just noticed something. Have you seen this laser? It goes straight through your base.
Wait a second.
I broke it.
Hold on. I have an idea. Hold on. I don't know if this is actually going to work. It may work.
Uh-oh. I'm excited.
Okay. I'll move this down some. Hold on. Move. Rotate. This is me completely going ADHD. It does go to my base. Hold up. Let's take a detector.
Dude.
Detector to my side.
Move. You don't think how you can place this and like people drive past, it could trigger stuff to happen in your base?
Yes.
And prank people and stuff like that. How cool. Oh my goodness.
Oh no, it stops right here.
Oh no.
It's just not long enough.
Oh, maybe if I was like on the next plot along.
I'm not sure that would work.
Almost do it.
Would you stop distracting me? Seriously. We got a job to do.
I have a very short attention span.
It's like a goldfish, man. I'm serious. Come on, let's go.
Right, where was we?
Okay, turn that back on. There we go.
Okay, so that's going to be pretty cool then, so go in this direction. So I can actually now place like conveyors for the wood that is too small in directions that I want it to go now, couldn't I?
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Okay. This opens up so many possibilities for me now. Mm. On designs and stuff. Let me see if I can get some straight conveyors up there.
Rotate. I want to start right
here. Can I place it?
Oh, that was too low. My bad.
Perfect. On a scale of 1 to 10, with 10 being the most, how much concentration do you need right now?
Don't ask me that when I'm playing with lasers.
Just so I know how much I can distract you.
The game, see if you can distract code. I hate building. I hate trying to get it just perfect on there. Why can't I just like
Fine, good. You got this. It hasn't got to be perfect. My base is not perfect. Have you seen the mess? Wow.
Like, look at this. Look, I keep placing this thing down and it's like just over the lip. I'm like, seriously? Seriously? Okay, hold on. Let's try something here. Let's move this down. Oh, what if I turned it? We have an upside down laser. Oh, that didn't work. Turn, turn, rotate, rotate. Okay. Let's just go off the top here. Just off the top here. Just off the... Fine. There.
Whoa. Lasers.
All right.
Do you think it would be cool, like maybe at some point in the future, there'll be like an upgrade? Rather than sawmills that chop woods, we could have like laser beams that cut through the wood?
Yeah, I do believe it's Lumber Tycoon, not to...
not Future Tycoon!
Future Tycoon.
As it cuts the wood coming with the laser beam, the wood gets slightly toasted. White wood goes in white and comes out brown. See, I've got all the ideas.
Been watching too much Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. Two, three. Wait, what? What? You may only build on structures that are on your land. What?
I was gonna say, is it off the edge? But no, we've got plenty of space.
It's a bug. Devaltio! There we go. There's three, four.
Right, I just thought of some cool ideas now for my other sawmill setups. I can have them underneath this ramped section as well for some of them. Six. Oh, it's gonna be cool, Code!
Eight.
The concentration
ten.
Is real.
Ten. Is that 10? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's 10.
I can feel the concentration coming from you.
Oh. Now, actually, in the back of my head, I'm like, man, I'm going to mess this episode up. I'm so sorry.
Right, so... Oop. Nope, that's trying to turn that ray that way.
That's close. Close is good, right?
Yeah, close is perfect.
we'll just go with close. All right. Detectors. Come on, detective. Let's go.
Boom.
What is this? I didn't authorize this to be here.
I mean, just to add more confusion and break your concentration even more, I'm just not placing random stuff around you. Oh, I just thought it's something good. Right, I'm going to build a... Have you seen the people that can balance like rocks and stones on top of each other and they're perfect and they don't fall over?
Yeah.
I'm going to do this now with wood. And just create a huge tower of wood. And this is how I'm going to entertain myself. Don't get side distracted, Code. Just right. Act like I'm not here doing nothing.
Back to your knitting. All right, hold on.
Right, I need to turn you a little bit. Oh, no, it fell. I failed already. I failed on the first piece.
We're going to need... The XOR switch. By the way, the reason we're using an XOR switch is because we don't have another inverter. It's my fault. My bad.
We don't play by the rules, Code.
Turn.
We ripped up that rule book. We do it our own way.
Oof. I'll just put the XOR symbol on the inside so nobody can see my disgrace.
Act like it never happened. I'm actually really excited for this, just to see it work.
Oh, me too. I'm like, oh man, if this works, this is going to be awesome.
So is it easy to... okay, so once it's gone past the point of no return after the where it sorts it, how many more conveyors are we going to need after that before we place it into a... or do we drop it onto something? I don't know how this is going to work. Because I could do the end setup. Placing conveyors and stuff.
Let's see. I would say... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'd say 5. Right about here.
So is that for the ones that are too short?
Yeah, well, this is for the ones that are okay size. And what
the ones
do,
that you,
yeah, what they'll do is they'll come on in, they'll drop in and go to your sawmill and be sawed like that. The ones that aren't, they'll come out straight, cut, drop, and then they'll be on another conveyor belt system here, come across, and then they'll already be on the conveyor system. So the ones up drop down to this one. And these will already be on the system.
Okay. Right, so see how I've got this straight one that comes off here that I've placed up here?
Hmm?
Would that be beneficial to do, rather than a straight, a ramp down?
Actually,
what are your thoughts on that?
Might not even need it. By the way, it's upside down. Just so you know.
Damn it. Scared.
I'm like, why are the little things at the bottom?
Why you gotta notice stuff like that? Wait, is that the right way up? Did I do it? Am I no?
No, still upside down.
Right.
You gotta hit T. If you're hitting R, you're just like spinning it in a circle upside down.
Shh. I didn't do that.
I totally like saw it in my mind. I'm like, what is he doing? Oh, that's what he's doing. Oh, come on. All right. Let's move this.
Okay, this is going to be the struggle now. Come on. Easy does it.
This logic is like really compact. In your face.
Yes. I got it on. Yay! That was such hard work. I'm just going to take a 5-minute break now. Is that okay?
Okay, cool.
I'm so tired. You're doing such a good job here. It looks very tidy.
Yeah, it's about to get messy. A little bit.
Uh-oh.
Here's where the confusion and stuff comes in, because you're going to be like, what is he doing?
I know. You see how I perfectly placed down this sawmill as like a stand for you to stand on? I was like, I thought, you know, even though that wasn't the thinking behind it, but it all worked perfectly. Ooh. Now, can you actually use neon wires to do that kind of stuff? Or is it just got to be normal wires?
You can use neons if you want. Do you got a particular color you want to use?
That was just an idea.
Yeah. I think Mommy has it where hers, as soon as it starts cutting, it goes from green wire to like a red wire. So she knows it's cutting.
Wow.
Yeah, it's really cool.
That's really good.
I'm going to go from here out to the side. I'm not going to be able to go that direction, am I? Okay. This is not going to be pretty, but it's going to look awesome.
I don't mind. Sometimes the unprettiest things look amazing. Just look at my house. It's an eyesore.
Look at that. That is so confusing. It's like, wait, why are those wires touching? But if you look, this wire, like...
Oh. I like the confusion. I like the mystery behind it. Like, which way is going where?
Triggered.
Yep, it's triggered.
Okay, that works. And triggered. Triggered. Rotate. Okay. You know what? I'll just stand on it. Oh, it's too low.
Too low?
Wait, what? Boom, boom, boom. Don't look. I just used that in a 1x1x1.
It's okay. I've got this one coming up now. All right, does it get triggered? Yep, it triggers.
Sweet. All right, we're good.
Perfect.
Okay, now to hook up the second part of the logic right there in the middle. That'll be good.
Let's go. Just want to say, Cody, you're doing such a good job.
Thanks. You too.
Fact, yeah, yeah. I mean, I'm in contender for employee of the month. I don't know about you, Code. You've been slacking lately.
Just for that, I'm going to confuse you by crossing the wires over here.
Oh, no.
You're going
to
look at this.
But I need to make myself useful. Well, I'm going to make myself useful. I'm just going to move these boxes over here for you.
Thanks.
It's okay. It's just the little things. There we go. And I'll bring some of these wires over this way a bit. You know, make myself look busy. yeah. Not bad, not bad, not bad.
All right, is this the sustain? This is the sustain. Close. Move. This is going to go on the underside.
So I was really impressed with my little beautiful design of these sawmills and the conveyors, and now it's just
it looked good. It looked good.
It looked good, you know.
As a
for the
as
time
a,
I had it
as a lumberjack, you'd kind of get laughed at, but, you know. There's got to be designer lumberjacks.
It looks good, but yeah, yeah.
We need to go.
Practicality behind it was non-existent, but it looked good. Right. Okay, so
that is. That's the right direction.
While you're doing a bit of that, I'm going to finish off some of my roof in my storage barn because I feel so helpful and I'm doing so much work today. Code, just going to pull it out there. I mean, if I don't win Employee of the Month, then it's a fix. I'm going for the big bonus, the Christmas bonus coming up, and I'm looking for that promotion. That's what I'm looking for, the promotion. I've been working hard. My sales figures are up this month.
You seem so nice when you're like, hey, can you come do this for me real quick? You know, it'd be kind of cool. And they're all like, yeah, I'm doing all the work. It's all me. Wait, what?
I have no knowledge behind what you're doing, playing with wires and these stuff. I'm just
playing with wire. Man, just jeez.
You make it look so easy. Just I'm not even going to begin to pretend I know what's going on. But yeah, I see that wire had to go to that part. Yeah, I knew that bit.
Right, I was just about to do that.
Yeah, you kind of beat me to it there.
All right, so the first one gets triggered. Actually, here, to do this, we can just turn these off. First one gets triggered. And second one gets triggered. Nice. See what it did there?
Sweet. I did.
Yeah. So we need to invert that. It's completely backwards.
not it's all you.
So let's.
I'm trying to think of designs now to go with because, as much as I liked my impractical conveyor system I had just, it was so beautiful. It's going to be missed. Rip in pieces. It's literally in pieces everywhere right now.
Let's see here. I did not anticipate that. We need to invert that switch. The signal. That thing. Let's see. What is this? Is this an XOR? This is an XOR, right? Yeah, we can do XORs. XOR, like, I didn't even think about it, but it works great as an inverter. We just works.
Can I pretend that was my idea?
Sure, yeah, that's totally Seniac.
Yeah, it was a great idea I came up with, you know, just thinking outside the box.
This is going to look awesome, by the way. People are going to be like, why'd you use an XOR there? And be like, it's brilliant. That's why I did it. Oh, come on. Got it. And that'll be like a little on-off switch. So you could just be like, I'm just going to turn it off today. Do you have? So a, you know. Sorry. Do you have a switch, real quick?
A switch. Oh, should lever. Be my storage bomb.
Lever. So you're about to
run over there. So after you, well, we've got the bit where it turns there, but how many conveyors do you reckon we're gonna need for the bit that goes straight on? Because I can throw those on now.
Let's do five.
Just to
be safe.
All right. Is it just the one switch you need?
Yep, that's it.
Okay. I can make myself useful now. I'm placing some conveyors on there. There you go. Teamwork makes the dream work, code. Just saying. Right, let's try and place this on.
I want to call you a dork so bad, but I know I'm the same way, so. All right, get on there. It's not going to get on there. The wire is like, no, it's not having it.
Just believe in it, code. Believe in it.
No, I'm going to move the wire. The wire's in the
first
way.
Place it there. So first place it there, code. You got a vision that it's it, that it's there.
Visualize the switch going in place.
Right, I got three on, so we need to toggle those so they go in the right way. There we go. I actually like this because if you think about it, is it high enough for a car to drive underneath it?
Maybe a little car. Not a truck.
Because it'd be some, you know, really cool tunnel into the base that you could create.
Yeah.
Ooh, the ideas code. The inspiration now flowing from your design. I like it. Right. Okay, just can't switch that over. There we go. One more. It's beautiful. Beautiful. Right, I've got one more straight line somewhere. Steal it from over here.
This is such a mess of design. It's beautiful.
Let's have a look. What's wrong with this code? It looks good.
All right.
I think it looks beautiful, code. Don't worry about what everybody else thinks.
Why is that
not? I still love it.
On. Wait. Is one of them on? One of them not. Hold on. Let's finish that. Okay. Think of my logic. How's this working? All right, so both those are on. No, only one's on. Both those are on. There we go. Okay, that toggles that. Okay. So let's get that last wire. Wait, is there another wire? No.
You need another wire?
One more.
Okay.
One more for this part. This isn't even the saw part yet.
Oh, there's one here.
Oh, there it is.
Yay! I was almost, my heart went then. I thought I had to do some work. And go get another one. Whew. Got out of that one.
You're going to have to do some work, didn't you? Oh, geez.
Yeah.
Okay, there we go.
Right.
So it's
after these five straights, what's going to happen then?
We're going to want a cross wire. Actually, I told you wrong. Let's see. One, two, three. So this tin length right here, this one, yep. Two, three, we actually need from here, one, two, three. So you can take these last two out. This is going to be our cutting area.
Okay, so okay.
I told you wrong. But no, you're fine. Yeah, go ahead. You're good.
Yep. Okay.
All right. So, log comes in, clicks on the first one, turns off. Then it clicks on the second one, turns off, and triggered.
Yeah.
Comes across. And let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. About 12 seconds delay. I don't know if that's going to be long enough. or short enough. That'll be fine. It'll be fine.
Perfect. Okay.
Sorry, I got the I gotta smooth out my eyebrows because I just did the concentration look for like the last 10 minutes. Okay.
Yeah, I'm just gonna pretend I knew what was happening there. Yeah, I agree, Gerd. 12 seconds. Perfect.
Do you concur? Alright, let's go ahead and destroy. Destroy. Oh, you know what? It's on your base, so I cannot destroy. What's that? All these tiles up here. I need you to
destroy.
Okay,
I'll take care of those. I'll take care of those.
Destroy those.
Do, 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 do.
Let's go. Two. Design. Large floor.
Destroying.
Large floor. Right here. Done. And turn. We want this right in the middle on top of that floor. Come on, get up there. And B. Destroy not the vertical one, but the horizontal one.
Which one?
The flat one. The one that's going with the same direction as the conveyor belt, not the one standing up.
Bye.
Perfect.
I think maybe you say, oops, wrong one.
Oh, come on down. Oh, no, right there. Perfect.
Ooh.
And we're going to rotate. Line this up. Right there. Perfect.
Oh, that scares me. That looks so scary. It looks evil, Code. It looks so evil.
You're going to need a pressure plate. Pressure plate. Do you have a pressure plate?
I've got something in the storage. I'm not sure it's a pressure plate or those things that move, if that makes sense.
It looks like a little wooden plate with a little blue button on one side. If not, I've got two, one.
No, I haven't. I've got those metal plates that can rotate. People use them like garage doors.
Nope, not those.
That's all I've got.
You're good. I'm coming back. I've got it.
Whoop,
whoop. Whoop, that's the sound of the police. Whoop, whoop. Sorry.
What is a tree growing here? Hello, tree. Goodbye, tree.
Is he 10? If he's 10, go test him. Oh, he's not 10.
He's a little boy. Wait, so if he's not 10, he would go to the all turns, mm-hmm. wouldn't he?
Yep, he'll go into the turn.
Let's see this happen then.
Oops. I mean, Eureka.
Right, so going up the ramp now. I'm very excited. Very excited. This is going to be good. So it's going for the first laser beam. It was too small to get it, well, too low to get detected by it, but that's okay because it instantly goes that way anyway.
And that'll fall off. Bam. Boom. And that'll be on the conveyor belt already.
Nice.
So I need you to destroy this blueprint.
Yep.
And
I'm on it.
We're going to need some more wires. I'll be right back.
More wires, you say?
I'm still in your truck. Grand Theft Auto.
I'm telling the policeman. Hello, 911. State your emergency. Yeah, this guy kind of stole my truck. What does he look like? Well, he's got some gold headphones on. He's very pale. It looks like he could do with a nice holiday in the sun.
Oh. All about the suntan, isn't it? All about the suntan. Oh. Sorry, I just stood up there and I actually disconnected my headphones, so I don't know what other insults you were saying to me.
Shh. You have to watch the video back.
Oh, no. Oh. There's one. We're going to need one, two. We're going to need one for the pressure plate to the first sawmill, or chop saw, and then from the first chop saw to the second chop saw, so that's going to be two wires, and then we're going to need guidelines, and you're going to want one, two, three, four, so four, five, six total. I just bought one, two.
Ooh.
205? 205. Yes. Yeah. Got it. So, my daughter, whenever she's talking to Tom, she uses baby talk. I'm like, little girl, you are 9 years old. Stop talking. She's like, but Tommy's got this little antlers on his head. I'm like, stop it.
Oh, that's how I want to talk to him now.
Every time you go up to buy wires from this man with antlers and big manly mustaches standing there, and you're like, oh, he's so cute, he's with a button.
Oh, he's so cute.
I've lost count. Okay, one, two, three wires. Got three wires. Let's go.
Right, so I can already visualize in my head what's going to happen. So when it cuts through, when the sawmill cuts through the wood and it drops down, I'm thinking it then goes on the conveyor down below underneath it, but then reverses, goes the opposite direction it came in, and then turns and follows through. This is going to be so good code.
Mm-hmm.
I can only see, this is perfection. I need to move this the truck plate. Just place you there. There we go. Oh, yeah.
Oh, I'm never in third person. Why did I go third person that time? All right, one, two, three, four, five. I've got five.
Yay.
Jackson 5.
A, B, C.
D, Z is 1, 2, 3. Sorry, it was stuck in my head, too. Buy a wire for 205. Yes.
Okay. Right. Is this going to line up perfect, or...
Thank you, Tom.
It's gonna be very embarrassing.
I think Tom's a spy.
He could be. He really could be. Ooh. Whoa!
Jibboop. Alright.
Came in there on two wheels, doing the Italian job. Ooh, nearly got stuck again then.
Oh, something's in the path. There we go. Finished. There we go.
Right, I'm just going to make some room now for my sawmill. Yep. I need to move these. Let's move these over there. Now, lining this up is going to be interesting. But then again, I need to place in all the conveyors down so I actually know and judge the distance.
I'm going to borrow this for a second. Touch.
Oh!
What do you think of that?
That's really cool.
Now, is it coming,
I like it.
Is it coming down far enough? Like, will it actually cut wood that's on there?
Yeah, okay. Let me see if I've got like a... Oh yeah, I should have a long enough piece over here that we can test it out. I got a little plank over here. Now it is quite low, but you know, if it chops this, then it's perfect.
I think it's not low enough.
We'll soon find out.
Get up there. We're gonna have to redo that entire thing. That entire scene. Cut.
Yeah. Now, I think it could be good. I don't know. Well, we'll see now. I got this piece coming up. Oh, which is too low to get detected by the I should have seen that coming. Right, we'll throw it over. Oh, it's chopping it, code!
Oh.
It chopped it! It's perfect.
Oh, hold on. Let's see this piece.
Is that long enough, or will that just fall down?
Ooh, it's just gonna fall down. Hold on, hold on, hold on. Ow, my head. Okay. And Bobby. Oh, I fail. I fail and I fail. Get it?
Oh, 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 oh.
I don't know that that's... Those saw blades are not low enough.
Yeah, ready? Ready?
Oh, wait. It's perfect. Oh, it's good.
It's perfect. And it comes down again. Chop, 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 chop. Dude, that is perfection right there. That is all we need.
Throw the guidelines on them.
All right. Let's move this out of the way. So got a tiger leopard print now with cuts on the piece of wood. Nice. I need to move these conveyor supports out of the way then, so I can build the conveyor system underneath. So this is going to be very interesting.
Want to kind of guide this into the center. So that's what I'm going to do right here.
I place you down. So my idea is, you see where these conveyors are now, just down below?
Mm-hmm.
To fall on there, then it goes the opposite, like it comes back on itself and then goes basically underneath here and then turns, which then the little bits that fell off too small, then fall on the conveyor underneath into this sawmill. Oh, this is perfect. Code, you're a genius.
Oh, thank you. Two this points away.
Do you need this on the floor here? This
the sustain?
Yep.
No, we should be good on a sustain.
Right, I'm just going to move that out of the way a second. There we go. And rotate you. Oh, this is so cool. Oh, this was something cool as well. I can put like a really big glass wall here. Now, I don't know about you in America, but over here, there is a Krispy Kreme shop. Store.
Yes.
And did they do this in America? They have like all the big machines and conveyor systems of making the donuts, and you can stand behind the window and watch it all.
Uh huh. We got those.
Yeah. So that's what I'm thinking here. Like, I do a big glass wall here, and people can just come and stand here and drool over my wood being chopped up. That's what I do. I just stand there and drool over the donuts, like Homer Simpson. Oh, donuts. Right, I have to find the turn in just a moment. Get the turn now. Oh, this is going to be quite difficult now to place in this, or kind of work out where that turn needs to be. Right. Move you.
Wait, why did that trigger? Did that get triggered? I got triggered. Why did you trigger?
What happened?
Oh, okay. This blueprint that's right here?
Yep. I was using to delete it.
Yep, delete that blueprint.
It's gone.
Oh, I don't get it. Why is that wire still?
Have you broken it, Code?
Yeah, I broke it. Something got broken.
Code's broken, everybody! This is why we can't have nice things.
I didn't do it!
I swear, Mr. Seniac, it wasn't me!
That's what it was. That wire was triggering that, but it was so far away from it. I don't get it.
Logic.
Won't try and understand it. Let's move on. Keep moving. Nothing to see here. All right, grab that one. Oh, no, we don't want tiny. We want big. Let's do a large tile. There we go. Large tile right there. Right there.
Right then.
Beep. Move. All right. We want it right about here. And then
is that lined up or is that
to there?
Oh, it's not lined up.
What is that?
Close, but no cigar. What's going on?
It did it again. Hold on.
Hmm.
Watch this. This is silly. All right. I'll put this down.
Yeah, so that's the pressure plate then, and it's being triggered by. It's.
Do you see that?
It's not. Yeah, it's not. Is it because? I'm just going to take a stab in the dark. Is it because the wire passes through where the sawmills would be, which triggers a chain reaction into the wire that goes down to the pressure plate, maybe? Or is it just because
that wire shouldn't do it that far away? That's more than enough distance away from the plate itself.
Okay. How about placing the blueprint, then place another blueprint next to it. The wire that blueprint's on is not touching the pressure plate, if that makes sense.
Oh, I gotcha. Okay. Yep. Let's move this down here. Finished. I need you to destroy that blueprint. Wait. Don't touch it yet.
Yeah. Place another blueprint down and I can destroy that one so the blueprints aren't touching. Blueprints must carry electricity code.
Ah, it's got redstone.
Right, did you place one down? Can I destroy it?
Yep, I got the tiny one done.
Right, this will be quite interesting to find out.
All right, here we go. This one's not touching. Finished. What?
Okay, right. It's not because it passes through where the sawmill would be. That can't be the reason why, can it?
No.
How about you make it come down and then up, so as it like it dodges the hole where the sawmill goes down? Would that work?
It's just mad. I don't know what to do now. Oh, here. I know.
You know where you're...
I got it.
Oh, you got an idea?
Yeah. I got it. Get this idea. Let's move the floor. We're going to rotate. Because all I got to do is just get it over there. That's it. There we go. You can destroy this tiny one right here. Doink.
Yep. On the way. Boom, boom, boom. Grab my ramp over here and do this perfectly. So, to you. Nice. I actually need more. Is it okay?
Yeah, I just like the way you said nice.
there's a wire.
Finished. There we go. We might do the same thing on the other side, since we did have to come out a little bit.
I need some more straight conveyors.
Yeah, let's do that. Can we do that? Maybe we can do that. P, 3, 2. This is going to be the boring part that we're going to have to cut out later. Be like, oh my gosh. It's taking so long for him to finish this.
I wonder why that was, why it was doing that then, like bringing the sawmills down.
That's weird
because, you know, just simple logic is just nowhere near any of it.
A wire is floating out in the middle of space in front of a pressure plate. Does it trigger? Of course not. Failed your test. It was a trick question.
Lumber Tycoon logic.
There we go. Got a crisscross pattern going on there. And that is definitely less than 10. So, if it can get past that and drop, then you should be good. Unless we want to do one more? Could do one more. That'd be cool. Yeah, let's do one more. Why not? For fun. For fun and adventure. No, just kidding.
Yay!
Actually, we could probably fill those in, and those would be like side guides.
Hmm.
So that way nothing falls off the sides in case it like flops.
That would be a good idea.
Let's do that. Let's destroy. Oh, yeah, I can't destroy things. Destroy the two blueprints.
Yep. Destroyed one. I have almighty power.
Two. Let's put up some walls. Smooth walls. No Trump jokes there. Rotate turn. And rotate turn. There we go. Oh, oh, oh. Come on. Come on. Whoa. All
right, this little conveyor system down here. It's going to be temporary, but at the moment, it's going to do the job.
No, that's perfect.
And I'm just hoping... I'm not sure if that's going to be just one-off, maybe. No, I think it should work. Maybe. Oh, no, I got this over here I could use. Okay. So if I place one of these at the very end code...
Yeah.
If I had it placed right, I could also use it then as a basic, like, you know, sawmill to, like, put stuff on. It doesn't have to go up there as well. So, like, there's two ends to this.
Yeah. Mm. If you're using, like, little oak trees and you know they're not going to be tin.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, perfect. Okay.
Oh, I can't not get bad. That to move.
All right, how's it going? Or do I ask?
It goes. I don't know where it's going, but it's getting there.
Definitely goes.
Here, let's test that out. Let's throw a big log in there. Any elm trees? Right, right here.
Is there a big... Ooh. Oh, perfect. It like it knew that we needed to use it.
Timber on my base. Turn around.
I'm gonna call
what's
it
going
now.
On, guys? Both of us.
I'll call it now. It falls down onto your truck, glitches your truck out, and goes flying. I'm calling it now.
Okay. So on the truck. On the truck. Here we go.
On the truck.
Timber.
Oh! Boom! Yes!
Called it. Oh! Oh! Right,
$10,
oh! No glitch! No glitch! No glitch!
Oh, no glitch! Okay.
Don't be jumping into it, being like, "Oh, I'm going to glitch this thing."
Oh, I'm so excited to see this doorbell work.
This is
mighty fine chop powers.
This is where the fail happens. So, if the fail is going to happen anywhere, it's right here.
It's right at the end when we test to see if it works.
Oof. That's definitely over 10. Oop, it's definitely. Come here, you. Get out of there. There we go. Got it. Oh,
I'm excited. I'm so excited.
You want to do the honors?
No, your contraption. If it messes up, it's your fault.
You got everything right. Turned on? Yep, everything is turned on.
Okay, here we go. This is the moment of truth. Will it work?
Will it blend?
Now. Right, here we
There's
go.
There's one. There's two. No! Wait.
Oh, it stopped. It's thinking. Why is it stopped?
No, it did. Code. It did work. It. Hold on. It did work.
It worked until it hit, and the thing didn't open up quick enough.
Yep, it didn't open up quick enough. All right, let's do it again.
Maybe you move the lasers down a little bit further. Right, we shall see now. Could have been a first time hiccup. Here we go.
All right, first laser triggered. Did you see what it just did? Oh man, come on.
It's weird, even though why does it stop though? That's the weird one.
It's It's one of the bugs of the conveyor system is that it will definitely stop first. Definitely stops.
Yeah. Oh!
It went through.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, it got lined up.
Goes in, hits it, drops it up.
Oh, please drop, please liking drop, please it. Drop, please drop.
Wait, have I got all these conveyors the right way around? Yeah. It works!
It's beautiful. Now that piece is stuck.
That's okay, that can be readjusted. Oh, no, yeah, I knew I messed up somewhere.
I would call that a success. That is a good success.
That is a success. Look, we've got this wood. We haven't touched it. Oh, hang on. I still messed this one up as well. How have I messed up such a simple part of it?
No, I did touch that one as it was stuck up there. But I'm willing to bet.
It is a success. We have wood that's gone in, being sawmilled by the big chainsaw things. Circular blades.
You might put a straight conveyor on one of these.
Yeah, like, this is just a temporary setup, but it works.
I love it.
It doesn't work at the moment, but the idea works. I believe it works.
Now, do you want me to move this in just a little bit? That way it's got its that delay doesn't happen so bad.
Is it a simple fix?
I think so. Come on. Is anything ever simple with me? Ever?
Well, as you will, if you want.
Oops, upside down. See that?
All right. What I'm going to do is make the ramp up a little bit earlier, maybe by one, to see what happens then. This could be the simpler. Oh, nope.
Oh, we're upside down again. How did we end up upside down again? All right, let's move. We're going to do a turn, rotate. Perfect.
All right, let me see if this now is okay. It would help if I had the conveyors going the right way. And perfect. Just made it ramp up one little bit earlier. Code, this is a huge success.
Awesome. Congratulations, sir. Congratulations.
It's all you. It's all you. You did everything.
No, we're gonna do
this. Right, should I chop down another large piece?
Sure. Yeah. We can run through one more test real quick.
Yeah. Okay. Let's grab this piece here.
By the way, this logic looks awesome.
Right, chopping. We're almost there.
I'm gonna put this stuff crossing all over the place. This is gonna be awesome.
Right, I got the big piece ready to load. Just tell me when. Just right, say the magic word.
One second. And do it.
Okay, here we go. Right, so it can only be perfected now. So let's see what happens. Here we go.
The anticipation is like killing me. Oh.
I mean, it can't get any worse, can it?
Oh, yeah.
Right, goes through. Oh, look at that for timing code.
Give it, wait for it, and
that.
Oh.
Is... Uh-oh.
Okay, I'm going to blame this one on Midget. This is your fault right here, okay? I don't know why, but that's definitely you. You did that.
That's okay, though, because this is, you know, a simple move. Mm-hmm. The main part, the genius behind it is the sorting bit. Sorts it to go in directions.
Mm-hmm.
But after that, maybe you could do with actual the... I don't know. What could you do? to make that more perfected.
Can we just do a conveyor right there?
That's what I was thinking. Will it go for the conveyor and chop it up?
Yeah. Here, let me get rid of these wires. And just grab another little short piece there.
I'm going to have to go into my storage barn. Oh, no, there's one here. There we go. Running over now.
Get these out of your way for you.
Right. Rotati. Okay, so that needs to go. You need to make sure I get it the right way around. Well, okay, that should be good. Right. Very important job for Seniac. Will he place this on?
Is it being moved around? Yeah, hold on. I think this wire is going to be in your way. Let's move that down. Finished. Is that better? A little bit better?
Baham! There we go! There we are. All right, let's make sure that is also facing the right direction. There we go. Okay, so should I throw this back up then? This little piece?
It's not going to work.
It's not going to work with this piece?
No, the conveyor is not going to work. Like, it's going to cut off like a bread slice at the end. Oh, never mind.
That was just too small anyway. To actually get there, but I don't know. I'm going to try one more piece.
Go for it. This is the testing stage. We're in beta.
Yeah. Right, let me chop this bit. Third time lucky code. Right, there we go.
Twice a bridesmaid.
Right, here we go. This is it now. This is the final. This is perfection right now. It's about to hit it. Okay. Let's move you out of the way. Right then. Here we go. Will it do it again? Because last time was so perfect. Oh, look at that. You have got that put to perfection code. Right, and here we go. It hits.
Good.
It chops.
Does it drop? It didn't drop. It didn't. Seniac, it didn't drop. It's not dropping. Seniac.
No code.
I told you it wasn't going to work. Your episode is ruined. I'm so sorry.
What have you done, code?
No.
What have you done?
I give up. I'm done. No more. No. Never.
No. Now we cry.
Seniac.
Okay. I'm going to throw a curveball.
I fail at dying.
You jumped in the water. I was going to throw a curveball in there and say a ramp down.
That might work. And I'm dead.
Just because it's so long that it won't go down anyway because it's still got weight on the lug. You failed me, code. You failed me. Get out.
Get out. I'm still thinking.
Right.
If this. Okay, so you removed the one, right?
Yeah, I'm just going to try and place... you able to move that little lug for us?
Wait, what? Oh, yeah, I can... grab that, maybe. There we go. Get that out. Let me grab this.
Okay, so it's not liking my placement there. Why you don't like my placement?
Because that wire is in the way again.
Try and place that. Oh no. There we go. No. Okay.
I got it. I got an idea. So with the crisscross wires, we were doing good.
Yeah.
We were just not far enough out. We want a single crisscross wire, not a double.
Wait, rather than wires, couldn't we just place like a plank of wood going so far out?
Like
underneath where the wires would have been.
The reason you want it to be a crisscross wire is so it can't balance on it because it's rounded.
Oh, gotcha.
Just got a message from Mummy. Must be a good game. Love Mummy. Smiley
right,
faces.
Code, we can do this, right?
Okay. Alright. I can get this done. Let's get this done. Our do viewers
it,
right. deserve
I get one more wood. One more wood. And if it fails at this attempt, then so be it.
And that'll be that.
The universe is telling us that Seniac can't have a sawmill.
I think it'll work.
Right. Which piece did I get? This piece.
This right here is going to be perfect. It's going to be perfect. Like you can't. Right. Tell you me can't when. Mess this up. You can't mess this up.
Okay. Good to go.
Yep. You're ready.
Right. Here we go. You know that old that saying, fourth time lucky. That popular saying that everyone says, fourth time, it's about to happen, code, fourth time.
I thought that was third time's a charm. Wait a second.
The timing you've got on that sorter is just perfect. It's unreal how perfect it is. Okay, here we go, Ian. Oh, he's done it, boys and girls. He's done it.
That's going to work. That's going to work.
He's done it.
There's one.
Oh!
There's
yes, code.
Two.
That's fine. The second one's always going to have a little hiccup. I know this. But that's
no,
long
it,
enough
it
for it not to
See?
Be cut anyway.
See? Perfect.
Yeah, they didn't exist. Code. Perfect. I mean, that second piece anyway is, you know, that's okay. That's long enough for it just to be thrown down on the second conveyor straight away by myself. But the main logic behind this, it sorts it, it chops it, it falls down, it goes into the sawmill. You've done it, code.
From everything that you had before, you had nothingness, and there's awesomeness now. So I'm
yeah,
yes.
I had nothing. I definitely have something now.
I'll give you employee of the month.
No, it's still me. I think everybody should comment down below. Out of all of that, who gets employee of the month? I'm just gonna say it's me. You know, not biased or anything. But right. Dude, thank you so much for the help. This I couldn't have done it without you. You know, you don't know how easy you've now made my life in this game.
Yeah.
I cannot thank you enough, dude. I cannot thank you enough.
You're welcome.
Do you want to take us out, code?
Let's take us out. Thank you, everyone, for watching this episode of Lumber Tycoon 2 with me, Code Primate, Heath Haskins, and I'm joined by Mr. Seniac with the awesome Saul today. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe down below. Likes, the links are going to be in the comments, and you know, the normal story stuff. Say goodbye, Seniac.
All that usual jazz.
Say goodbye to the fans. Love you all.
Goodbye.
And good night.